And joining us on Hot Copy, clearly this guy is busy. Public Works Secretary Rogelio Singson is with us. Good day to you, Secretary.
Thank you.
All right. Okay, now tell us about that first. So the government has released 2.208 million pesos for bridges that were destroyed in...
Karen, these are more for emergency repairs, but we really need much more than that. And especially the more permanent solutions to the problem in Cagayan de Oro and Iligan.
Yeah, now where are we when it comes to Cagayan and Iligan? Tell us.
Well, obviously what happened there was nagsabay yung high tide, no? At saka yung excess rainfall, no? The unfortunately, the situation in Cagayan de Oro is practically flat, no, doon sa city itself.
Yes.
So the high tide went as far as almost 5 kilometers inside the river.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I will show you charts that can.
Sure.
Ito yung high tide, ano?
This is Cagayan de Oro, ha?
Yes. Ito yung tide prediction, no?
Okay.
This is 2 a.m. in the morning.
Okay.
Sabay nung 99 millimeters rainfall ng alas dos ng umaga.
Okay.
No? So talagang babaha because the capacity of that river plus all the structures that
yes.
are on the riverways were not properly warned, and I guess
yes, yes.
they were a little bit complacent. Dahil sanay daw sila sa ganyang klaseng ulan,
uh-oh.
But not of that magnitude.
Okay.
At hindi sabay nung high tide.
Okay. No? So what is the DPWH planning to do to make sure that water doesn't come in 5 kilometers into the city? That's really inside the
yes,
city.
That's correct. So what we have to do is, which is what I kept explaining in the past, no?
Yeah.
Let's work upstream.
Uh-oh.
Rather than dito lang tayo sa baba, nandito sa baba.
Uh-oh.
No? Because if you try to anticipate a rainfall like this and
yeah.
you build a wall on the rivers, eh siguro wala ka na makikita ang river. They're up 4-5 meters ang taas niyan, but it cannot be that way.
Yeah.
No? So what we have to do is contain that water upstream.
Yeah.
No? And the technology that's been adopted by the department and which is already accepted in other countries is what they refer to as sabo dam technology.
Sabo dam. Okay. Why is it called sabo dam?
This is apparently a term coined in Japan. No. It's really for control of sedimentation and debris.
Yeah.
No, and the floodwaters. So you have a series of mini dams, no, and we just inaugurated two dams in Camiguin last Saturday.
Okay, we're going to show that, but before that, if you use the sabo dam technology in Cagayan de Oro, where will you put it?
We have started the assessment as to where we will put it and how big we will need to put
up. Where do you put it?
Upstream.
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 When you say, of course, upstream, to be layman completely,
sa itaas,
highest point of Cagayan?
Hindi naman. We will have to locate it properly, no?
Uh-oh.
Kung saan yung may choke point, no? Kung saan yung medyo vulnerable to landslides.
Yeah.
Kasi what you do with sabo dam is, kinokontrol mo yung putik, yung mga boulders,
Bato,
yung puno na bumaba at tumagasa.
Yeah. Can I tell you, yung isang barangay, sir, na pinuntahan ko, you know what wiped them out? Hindi lang tubig, bato.
Bato,
you
at
said
saka,
it.
Bato at saka yung troso.
Oo.
Walang matibay dyan. Yung aming tulay na nasira sa Iligan, 4 piers.
Yeah.
Yung isang pier doon, totally wala ka makikita ang anino. No? Talagang wipe out yung buong pier.
Now, do you put it upstream by the river or not necessarily?
On the river itself.
On the river,
on the
itself.
River itself.
Okay, so is it one dam or several dams?
Series. That's what
series.
We will have to measure. No?
Okay, very interesting. So, Secretary Singson gave us some photographs of Sabo Dam, which was inaugurated in Camiguin earlier. It's actually in graphics. Can we show that, Direk? Okay, we're preparing for that. All right. We're seeing right now, this is footage, pictures of Cagayan de Oro, actually. So this is there. This is how it was wiped out. Okay.
Karen, as you can see, this is all debris, mud, sediments, boulders, and cut logs, no?
Uh-oh.
Cut logs as well as uprooted trees that come down. And so the intervention there has to be both structural, yung mga dams, no,
yeah.
sabo dams, and non-structural, meaning people have to learn how safety measures and the community has to learn how to get the warnings properly.
Yes, and actually not live on geohazard areas.
That's correct.
But other than that, to also preserve bridges that were made, you have to control debris from coming down.
That's right, that's right.
Yeah.
Walang matibay na, tignan mo yan.
Oo.
Walang matibay na bridge yan, pagkatroso ang tsaka mga bato ang humagip riyan.
Oo, that's very interesting. I've never heard this kind of argument in the past. Okay, but you have some. You can show us right now, right here. Okay.
This is what we inaugurated.
Yeah.
That is the one in Camiguin.
Okay, Direk, can you show this? First on a wide shot. So this is Camiguin?
That is Camiguin.
No? All right.
So the width of this top is about 3 meters.
3 meters.
And this is about 9 meters, no? So pag may bumaba at rumagasa, ano?
Tubig
o troso o bato, may entrap siya rito.
Tama, no? Hindi na papasok doon.
Hindi na siya laragasa sa baba.
Oo.
Ang lalabas lang dyan, tubig.
Tubig.
No? Kaya may pipes dyan.
Correct. No?
So,
okay.
The more
now, how can we be sure that the dam itself is safe?
Look at this. No?
Okay.
This is another type of a Sabu dam. It is still type permeable. Ibig sabihin, look at that.
Okay,
no?
This is, what is this?
This is a steel.
Inside. This is the
concrete.
Dam.
Tingnan mo yung lahat ng trosong na-trap niya.
Ang galing.
No? So, yung troso na yan, hindi na bababa yan.
Oh, then you can collect it after.
That's correct. Then you maintain it regularly.
Yes.
So, diyan ka na lang maglilinis. Hindi ka naglilinis all over the river, which
very
is
good.
Very difficult.
This is Ormoc, huh? This
Ormoc.
Is how it looks now in Ormoc.
Yes,
to prevent the flooding that had happened.
That's correct.
Now, I find this interesting. Can you show this, sir?
Yeah.
This is concrete.
There are different types of Sabu dam depending on what you want to address.
Okay.
Kung lupa lang, bato ba yan, troso ba yan. So, ito steel naman, no? Kung halimbawa you need more water flowing in at saka bato yung kwan, you steel, no?
Uh-oh.
So this one just to control the flow of water, so solid yan, no? Para ganun, hindi sabay-sabay yung baba ng tubig.
Oh. Now this is a new technology.
No, this is an old technology, except that we have been fixated in terms of fixing downstream.
Ito na yung
sinasabi kong parati na, let's stop doing downstream. If we don't do anything upstream, masisira lang lahat yung ginagawa nating downstream.
Oh, so it's also a mindset.
That's
and
correct.
Actually exposure to technology,
that's
no?
Correct. That's
to
correct.
Options.
Yes, yes.
Okay, now where are you building the Sabu Dam technology?
We will be building them upstream of Cagayan River, Cagayan de Oro River, and the one in Iligan.
Okay, how much money will that take?
You know, I was given an estimate of how much we will need to improve the 1 kilometer, or what they call as golden mile in Cagayan de Oro pa lang ito, no?
Yeah.
920 million pesos, no?
That's not too big.
That's not too big. The two that we constructed in Camiguin, which we inaugurated last Saturday, cost us only 520 million.
Really?
So, mas mura talaga kung tama yung technology ng gagamitin.
And now you'll be saving billions of pesos.
And lives
instead of rebuilding from damage.
Taon-taon na ayusin mo yan dahil raragasa at raragasa yan sa baba.
Oo. Now, when it comes to the Cagayan River, Secretary Pahayad said desilting it was also
that
important.
That will be part of it. But
okay.
You cannot imagine if you don't do anything upstream, ano yan, taon-taon mo i-desilt? Imposible.
Oo, imposible yon.
Imposible. So you have to do something upstream. The intervention has to be upstream.
Uh-oh. What is the priority of the DPWH for this year?
For this year, we have identified the interventions upstream, itong Sabu Dam, plus the warning system.
Okay, and what is that?
The warning system is that
it's technology?
That's correct. We will use satellite technology
okay.
so that we can do predictive modeling.
Okay.
In other words, with this rainfall, with this capacity of the river, pag ganito kalakas yung ulan, gaano kalaki yung itataas ng river na yan. So that you can warn people along the river na, teka muna, alis na kayo dyan, in 2 hours, dadating yung ganito kataas na tubig.
Now, does every province need that or one early warning system nationwide is enough?
The directive of President Aquino is for us to deploy about 1,600 all over the country for all the major rivers. No?
Okay.
We will give priority to the river systems that have wide inundation area.
No? Yeah.
And these are already yung geohazard maps that we will be using, na ito yung malaking maapektuhan kung magkaroon ng excessive rainfall.
Uh-oh.
You see, what we have to do is, yung dating inuulan ng dalawang buwan o isang buwan, ibabagsak, in the case, 6 hours.
Yeah. No?
So you have such a huge outflow of water. But our design is good for 25-year capacity ng mga rivers. No?
Yeah.
Tinataas mo yung walls niyan for a 25-year.
Yes.
E itong sendong 75-year dumating. No? So ang laki, nung kailangan imbakin mo.
Yeah.
No? You have to retard that much water so that your river system can handle the volume of water that flows down.
Yeah.
So these are in the form of retarding basin, Sabo Dam.
Yes. Now, Sabo Dam, does it have a retarding basin?
It can be used as flood control as well as debris control.
Yeah, because I was thinking, you can use it as debris control, but is there a technology, sir, that you can actually use the water in the future for
That's
the
correct.
Town?
Ito na yung retarding basins
yeah.
that I kept mentioning in the past.
No?
Na you can use it for irrigation, for domestic supply, as well as for flood control.
Yeah, so will this have or
Oh yeah, we're designing them already in our major river systems.
Because look at Cagayan, no? Medyo, di ba, nawala ng tubig. If there were retarding basins after the tragedy, may
That's
tubig
correct.
Silang panggamit.
Ang nakakalungkot, ano? Ang nakakalungkot. We have such an excess rainfall.
Yeah.
But we only utilize for consumption, no? All uses not, only about 28%.
Yeah.
We have such a good renewable water source.
Very good
water
point.
Resource that we just throw out in the ocean.
To waste. Yeah.
And in fact causes us a lot of damage,
yeah.
loss of lives and property.
So is this another priority, major retarding basin for rainfall?
That's definite. So we have retarding basins for river systems as well as for urban centers.
Where
will urban
you put
center,
it?
Yung sinasabi ko na sa inyo na Fort Bonifacio
yes,
model.
Yes, oo. No?
Yung pang urban center. We should no longer allow big subdivision developers to continue to discharge all of that pipe water that they collect into the river system.
Yeah.
Hindi kakayanin.
Oo.
The city will continue to get flooded if we allow all of these big developers to discharge directly into the water system.
So where do we put the retarding basins?
They can be underground parks. They can be, as what we have shown in the Fort Bonifacio, this is above underneath a park.
Yeah, no? Which is like 600
six stories deep and
yeah,
72
yeah.
meters wide.
Yeah.
No? So that's the design. So that the creek behind Fort Bonifacio does not get flooded. No?
Yeah.
Kung i-direct discharge mo yun, yung buong kalayaan and EDSA will be flooded.
Yeah. No, you actually have amazing plans. And what I wanted to ask you is, we had Ben Jokto, remember, on the show.
Yes.
He had said actually that to spur the economy, we need to spend more of our GDP in public infrastructure.
That's correct.
China spends 7 to 8% of their GDP on public infra. And we are only spending 1%, which is like 180 billion this year?
No. I think we're close to 2.5.
Okay. No?
But ideally, we should put in, we've done numbers, no?
Yeah.
And we're really behind in terms of spending in, not just on roads.
Yeah, yeah.
We're behind rails, airports, seaports.
Yes, yeah. Which actually, if we spend a lot on that, you can hire people to work,
yeah,
then
employ,
they spend the money.
Employ,
yeah. So there's that cycle of business.
That's
that
correct.
Yes.
That's correct. Economic activity is definitely enhanced with infrastructure.
Okay, now what do you suggest to the president? What have you suggested that we spend?
Well, we have, in fact, for this year alone, aside from our regular budget of 125, we will probably be spending or at least contracting close to 200 billion just on DPWH alone.
Yeah.
But excluded from that would be the school buildings.
Yeah.
We're also accelerating using some other modes of implementing that public and private partnership. No, of course, a big chunk will also be pumped into irrigation, which is very important for food self-sufficiency. So makikita mo nakafocus naman dun sa programa ng Pangulo.
Yeah, because the sad part about the story of the DPWH as an agency is that all countries are spending on public infrastructure, but but the government scared to give to the DPWH because of the bad image of kickbacks and corruption. And now we're feeling it that China's so advanced. Hong Kong is like this, Singapore, but that's all DPWH.
That's all public works.
Yes. So Ben Jokno was saying you need 500 billion, the DPWH, if you want to pump prime the economy.
Well, the thing is, I don't think we're even ready to absorb that much public works
projects,
funds.
Funds. Okay. Yes. Why is that?
Well, the capacity. We don't have enough contractors who could possibly implement that. I have to meet with the Philippine Contractors Association to tell them we're running out of legitimate and good contractors based on the volume that we're doing. So we're asking them to participate, bring
already
in their members.
Uh-oh.
Because they have shied away in the past.
Yes.
Ayaw nilang sumali.
Bad nila, contractors puros, nga daw.
Puros kalokohan na mangyayari dyan. Nag-aaksaya lang kami ng pera. We don't deal with the politicians. They
yes,
don't wanna deal
yes,
with
I
that.
Understand. Yeah, and then in the past, they don't get paid. If they were good contractors na walang
nila,
lagay.
Nakikita naman nila competitive bidding, they get paid on time, and I run after our own people who delay payments.
Yes, good point. Okay, we'll take a quick break. When we return, Public Works Secretary Rogelio Singson will answer questions from you, our viewers. Hot Copy will be right back. Twitter's been busy already.